On the banks of the Ohio River in Cincinnati, we're here at Nippert Stadium. And now we bring you the coin toss, and it's presented by Nissan. Innovation that excites. Patterson is lined up to kick this one off, and you can feel the thunder in the crowd as they await the start of this game. He's to the 20. Tackle at the 30. Now the offense gets ready to take their first crack at it. He unloads it, and it's intercepted by the senior cornerback. He came up with a fantastic interception there.
Well, you know the quarterback is kicking himself for that one. He just made the wrong read.
It's first and 10. Ball on the 44. Gains his way to the 29-yard line.
He got the ball, and he was off like a shot. This guy has some big-time speed.
Tackle made around the 29-yard line. Picked up a yard of anything on that run. Throws complete, and he's hit hard behind the line. It's a loss of about three.
Really, they just had nowhere to go after the catch.
It's third down and 13 to go. Ball in the 32. They'll line up with five wide receivers. And he's shoved out of bounds around the 27-yard line. Williams gains about 5 yards on the play. The distance, and he just drilled it from long range.
Boy, he had plenty of distance there and pushed it through. Very impressive leg strength.
3-0, Memphis. Looks like they're ready for the kick. He's to the 20. At the 30. He's taken down at the 34. Flag down, and I'm not sure when it was thrown. Let's find out. That one's going to put him way back.
You just can't block a player from behind like that, or it's going to cost you.
I'm sure the quarterback would love to make amends for that last pick.
One general rule in any game is to hold on to the ball. If you're in the negative in the turnover department, your chances of winning decrease exponentially.
He's tackled at about the 27-yard line.
Very solid gain through the air. I'm impressed with the poise of this quarterback and the ability of the receiver to keep his concentration and get his hands on the football.
Handoff brought down quickly. He makes his way to about the 42.
Brad, I just think this quarterback's got to do a much better job of being able to read that defense and make quicker decisions. And especially when the defense starts to get pressure, you've got to either get rid of that football or check it down or take off and run with it.
Going deep, lays it out there. A junior makes the catch. tacks on the extra point.
A nice six-play, 82-yard drive, and they add 7 points to the scoreboard.
Brad, I thought the offense did a really nice job of mixing up the play calling on that drive. I thought the defense was on its heels most of the drive because of the versatility of the offense.
He's to the 20. Tackle made at the 30-yard line.
And while they are behind, they know they can knot things up in a heartbeat. It's way too early to change your game plan.
And he's level at the 48-yard line. He gets out to about the 48-yard line. And he's tackled
around the 37-yard line.
Good job here by the receiver to look the ball in and ensure he had possession. That's the right way to catch a pass.
And they make the stop
at about the 37-yard line.
You don't want to ever give your opponent a second chance, but that's exactly what they did by not making that interception.
It's third down and 10. Ball on the 37-yard line.
He zips it. The senior makes the catch, and he's taken down just outside the goal line. A heck of a play by the receiver.
We talk all the time about the emotions of college football. This play was definitely an emotionally charged play. What a way for the wideout to make a statement in this game.
He's taken down at the 1 yard line.
So the kicker will line up here and try to give his team a 3-point lead with this extra point.
And he converts the extra point.
Patterson has the ball all teed up, and he's ready to kick this one off.
He just drills this one. He's to the 20.
I love the competitive spirit that we're seeing out on this field today. It looks like one team has the upper hand, and then the other comes right back in to be able to regain the lead. It's going to be an exciting finish. Brad, let's see if this offense can maintain the rhythm that they established on that last drive. Not just putting points on the board, but driving the length of the field to be able to eventually put points up. I think that's going to be important for them to try to keep that confidence going here on this drive.
The quarterback trying to do a little too much by himself.
Hey, maybe next time he'll get it out to the back so he can do something with it.
Second down and 14. Ball on their own 25.
Nice gain as he works the right side.
That's how we do, D. That's how we do. They don't want to know. They don't want to know this.
And he's sacked.
Boy, this pass rush is sometimes scary. They're really getting after the quarterback now.
Smith is waiting for the snap.
Right.
He makes it to the 48-yard line.
The offense really came up with a nice drive their last time out, and most of those yards came through the air.
This defense needs to improve from front to back. The line needs to put more pressure on the quarterback, and the defensive backs need to stick it to these receivers with tighter coverage.
Memphis is up by three. Dangerous throw. This one's picked off.
He has to make better decisions than that. He should have known that there was no room to squeeze that ball in there.
This sophomore corner's got a ton of potential at that position. These coaches are really excited about what he'll do for the program over the next few years. First and 10. Ball on the 49-yard line. Scrambling around. Slides down to the ground. And he's hit before it can go anywhere.
When you can move the ball downfield in big chunks like that, you've got the defense right where you want them.
Nice run there.
Here we go!
The 17-yard line. They move the sticks after another first down.
Impressive drive by this offense so far. I really like what they're doing by keeping this defense on their heels and moving the ball downfield.
And he's going to come up with a sack. Well, they sent the cornerback, and he was able to make the sack.
The offensive line was just too slow to pick him up. By the time they saw him, it was just too late.
This is the eighth play of this drive. Touchdown, Cincy!
This kid is a really reliable weapon. You definitely want the football in his hands near the end zone, and he showed you why right there.
He makes the PAT. A 7-play, 52-yard drive, and they get it in for 7. The score now, 14-10. Cincinnati is lining up to kick this one off. From his own goal line, he's to the 20. He's tackled at the 26-yard line. The quarterback threw an interception on their last drive. Let's see if they can be more successful here.
He can't dwell on the interception. There's still a whole lot of football to be played today.
Throws complete. He's got room to work. And they finally knock him out at the 37. Makes the catch, and look out. He gets hit out of bounds at the 21. Makes it out to maybe the 19-yard line. It's third and 10.
Ball on the 20-yard line.
Wow, what a first quarter we had. That was an offensive explosion. 14-10, Bearcats. We can only hope the second quarter is as good as the first. Tight ball game, folks.
He's out of bounds at the 8.
I can't believe they actually got the first. This coach isn't afraid to take some risks.
Throws to the receiver. Got it for the touchdown. Trying to go up by 3. They'll kick the extra point. He splits the uprights with the extra point. Everyone's all lined up and ready for the kickoff. He kicks it off, and he got all of that one. He makes it out to maybe the 20-yard line.
In a game that's this close, you can't afford to waste possessions.
Throws right, intercepted. They'll bring him down around the 28-yard line. And the defense just picked up their second interception of the game.
This defense has really been in sync during the first half. If they keep this up, it'll be a long day for this offense.
From the 28-yard line, first down. Memphis has a 3-point lead. Throws it to the halfback on the screen. They'll drop him for a loss. Loss of about 2.
Pretty good stand there. They weren't fooled at all by the offensive play call.
Scramble. Tackle made at the 29-yard line. And he tackles him hard at the 36-yard line. Fourth and long here after the sack. The kick is up, and he got it. The kicker looks like he's ready to kick this one off. He sends this one deep. He's to the 20. Across the 30. Knocked out of bounds at the 45. Well, let's see if he can shake off that pick that he tossed last time out.
I look for the offense to come out with the same game plan as before. You don't make changes after one play.
He fights forward to about the 46. Him hard at the 47-yard line. the middle for a nice game. And now he's got room to run. He takes it right side for a good game. Fights forward to about the 36. They'll bring him down for a loss on the play. They'll line it up for a very long field goal attempt. Kicks away, and it falls short. No good. Momentum swings have been fairly even, and with so little separation, this game can be drastically changed on just one or two plays. Memphis, up six. He gets out to about the 42-yard line. Midfield.
Black five, black five. Connect. Orange three, orange three.
Crosses left, intercepted. He's tackled around the 47-yard line. So the turnover will once again give the ball back to this offense.
That's two interceptions today by this defense. Their coach has to be happy that they're forcing turnovers.
First down, 10 to go. Ball on the 47. And down he goes, around the 46-yard line. Before he could get back to the line.
Super job here by the defense of filling the gaps on the line. If you keep stringing out plays like that, you can really shut an option attack down.
Second and 14. Ball on the 38-yard line. Off balance and they can't connect.
Too bad that'll go down as an incompletion because he made a really great play on the ball to make the catch.
He sails it long. Incomplete. They call on the kicker for a long field goal. It's up. And this one doesn't have the distance. Now here comes the offense, and you've got to wonder if that last interception's weighing on the quarterback's mind at all.
This quarterback can make good passes. He just needs to focus on not forcing the ball to his receivers.
Got him, and he goes down quickly. Memphis with a six-point lead. And they make the stop at the 45-yard line. The 43.
love the toughness here by this quarterback of sitting in until the last second, trying to make a play downfield, only to have this defense get to him. He's got to do a better job maybe feeling things out a little bit, but at least he has the awareness and a toughness to sit in that pocket.
There's a strike complete, and he's down. And he throws it away. It's fourth down. They'll call on the field goal unit. Kicks up. No good. He pushed it to the right.
In a game that's this close, you can't afford to waste possessions.
Open man, quick strike, and he can't pull it in. From their own 37-yard line, second down. The quarterback in the gun with five receivers.
Here we go. Line up.
Fires out to his wide out, and he's tackled at about the 47-yard line. The offense going to try to open this field up, coming out in a five-wide set. And the defense counters with their dime look. And it's caught. And he's taken down around the 35-yard line. Short yardage situation here. Second down and one. They pick up good yardage that time on the pass play.
Here they kind of put pressure on the quarterback and challenged him to find the hole in the defense. And in this case, he did. Nice job.
He's taken down right around the 26-yard line. Steps out of bounds around the 23-yard line. From the 23-yard line, it's second down.
Here we go.
Pulls down the catch, and he's got room here. That's a great tackle at the 12. So the offense will move a little bit closer with that penalty. It's first down, and they'll be looking for 6 points here.
Mike three. Bumble. Ready.
And he is drilled at the three. So the old counter gets 2, maybe 3 yards. This is the 9th play of this drive. Cincinnati's going to have to use their second timeout of the half. The short yardage defense here. They keep it on the ground with a tailback. Touchdown, Cincinnati! Here's the extra point that can give them the lead. And he converts the extra point. Cincinnati gets set to kick this one away. The Bearcats had one of their key players go down earlier, but it looks like he might be able to get back in the lineup. He's to the 20. Makes it out to maybe the 19-yard line. The Tigers struggling trying to get their star wide receiver in this game. And sometimes, you know, Herbie, it's almost like a jump shooter in basketball. Get him to the free throw line, get him one free one from 15 feet and see how it can do. They got to get the ball in his hands somehow.
I agree with you 100%. I mean, it's just a matter of just one play, one touch to get this guy going, because he has that kind of ability. And up to this point, they've not been able to find a way to get him the ball. Give credit, a lot of credit to this defense for coming in with a good plan. But now it's up to the offense to make their own adjustments to kind of counter that attack by this defense to be able to get the ball into the hands of their go-to guy. down here by the defense. If you let this quarterback set and throw, he'll kill you all game. But they got excellent pressure on that play.
It's third down and five to go.
Ball on the 24. Give to the tailback. And he stopped behind the line.
The way the safety was playing up toward the line of scrimmage shows you what they think of the offense's passing game. Not a lot of respect for it.
Williams is waiting for the snap. He makes it out to maybe the 49-yard line.
6 points and a pretty display of passing was a result of their last drive. Kirk, do you expect the defense to take a different approach here?
When this quarterback is on, he is on. It already seems like whatever this defense is trying just isn't working. But maybe if they add just a little bit more pressure, they might be able to force him into a mistake.
A tight first half of football, and we head to the break. 21-20, Cincinnati.
We've played 30 minutes. Glad to have you with us on the EA Sports NCAA Football 14 Halftime Show presented by Nissan. Innovation that excites. David Pollack and I here in the studio to break down everything that just happened in your game. At times, this first half looked like a hunk of raw meat being thrown into water with a bunch of piranhas going after it. A lot of turnovers being forced. Tasty.
Yeah, you know, it's interesting because turnovers come in bunches. I mean, it really does. Once you get one as a defense, it just seems like they continue to come. And somebody flies to the football, and they put a helmet on the football. It pops out, and then you get an interception, and you can see it definitely starts to be contagious, and people become thinking about it more and place more of a premium on it, and people expect them. And once you expect them, and once you keep working for them, because you do the drills all week long. You know, you do the drills where the guy's running down the field, you pin the arm, you take the other hand, you strip the ball out. You do the drills where you're coming towards the football, you make sure you go up, you high point it as a defensive guy too to try to get interceptions. And once you start getting one or two, a lot of times they just keep coming and keep coming. And as a defensive guy, you're like, offense, it's all yours, dog.
That's going to do it at halftime. Just about ready to start the second half.
All right, you finish it up, brother. I'm going to get something in the cafeteria. I'm hungry.
Wait, don't leave until you get my order. Brad Kirk, take the second half.
And we welcome you back to the action here, just about set for the second half. Sends it sailing downfield. He's to the 20. And he's hammered down. There's still plenty of time to keep running their offense as usual here. I don't think they need to feel any anxiety about trailing. Quick out to his receiver. Tackle at the 33-yard line.
I think it was a great play call, and it was very well executed. Any coach would be happy with that kind of outcome on a first or second down play.
Inside the 44. Locked down at about the 25-yard line.
Option works, it can be beautiful to watch. But when it doesn't, it can go horribly wrong. Not a good result for the offense.
So now both teams come trotting back out onto the field.
Cincinnati is up one.
Set, down, cut.
He makes it out to maybe the 33-yard line. Steps out at the 37. They'll bring him down right around the 36-yard line. Smith awaits the snap. Tackle made at the 32. This offense lost the ball by way of a fumble the last time they had it.
So much in football is about how you respond to adversity. Moving forward after a turnover is a perfect example of that.
Man can't tack on any yardage.
Check three, check three, check three. That's a slant.
And he tackles him hard at the 41. Tackle made at the 50-yard line.
Right here, right here. 41's coming. 41's
the mic. Makes it out to about the 39.
You like to see a team having success like this running the football. It can really open up things for the offense.
Hey, kill. Four, five.
On the delay, and he's brought down immediately. And the defense just swarmed over him on that one.
Yeah, they were able to penetrate the offensive line and get to the running back before that play even had a chance.
Second down at 12. Ball on the 40. He gets rid of this one. It middle to the running back. He's tackled at about the 39-yard line. It's fourth down. They'll line it up for a very long field goal attempt. Memphis is trying to take the lead here. They try to get a head start there.
Maybe he got the cadence wrong coming out of the huddle. The coaches have a low threshold for mistakes like that. Yeah, Brad, that was nice. So now they're looking at a long way to go to even think about a score.
Well, you know the offense would like to generate more than they did on their last possession. Cincinnati, up a point. Tackled for a loss. It's second down. They're deep in their own territory. He makes it out to maybe the 7-yard line. A couple, maybe 3 yards on that run. You can bet the punter sweating to have to kick this one from his own end zone. Brought down at the 34. Flag down, and I'm not sure when it was thrown. Let's find out. So they'll move back after that costly penalty, and they'll have to try to get that yardage back here. We've got a first and 10. Ball on the 49-yard line. And they bring him down for a sack on the play. Montgomery awaiting the return. It was a quick three and out on their last possession. Cincinnati with a one-point lead. They'll run it inside and tackle quickly.
It's a great play by the defense, but it really makes you wonder, was there a miscommunication up front by the offensive line? They just seemed to allow the defensive line to get through, and the running back didn't have much of a chance at all.
Sets up a screen, tailback's got it, and they make the stop around the 32-yard line. Back's got it. He's pushed out of bounds at about the 37-yard line. Smith to punt. He gets it away, and this is a really nice punt. Fielded at the 19. He gets out to about the 28-yard line. I got to give this defense credit, Kurt.
Brad, I don't know what the heck's going on with this offense. They just haven't been able to come away with anything.
This deficit can be easily overcome, sure. But they have to be thinking if they don't get something going on this series, the burden is going to be felt by their defense. He goes out of bounds at the 32-yard line. He's scrambling, and he's tackled at the 46-yard line.
Easy,
easy. Nice run there. It looks like the defensive end that got in there.
Yes, it was. He did a wonderful job of fighting off blocks to bring the quarterback down.
From their own 45-yard line, third down. And he's taken down at the 45. Williams is the punter. He takes it in at the 14. What a collision! So they're just about set to get the game going again. Cincinnati is up one.
It's a bad play overall by the offense. The quarterback's doing everything he can to be able to make the play work and try to execute. The problem is the offensive line did not do a good job protecting him. They're very fortunate that ball wasn't intercepted.
He's taken down around the 22-yard line. Loss of one there for the halfback. From their own 22-yard line, it's third down. A great game so far, and it looks like it'll be decided in the fourth. The Bearcats lead it by one. Into the fourth quarter now, and we're back to the action. Gets it out quickly. We might look back on this game when it's all over and say that's the point where they won the football game with that stop. Smith is waiting for the snap. Booming kick. Williams takes it to 36, and he makes it out to about the 47-yard line. This is a pretty crucial series right here. With things being so tight, your best players have to step it up on both sides of the ball. Needed that play, and he dropped it. From the 47-yard line, second down. Left and can't get back to the line of scrimmage. Passes in and it's picked out of the sky. Out of bounds, right around the 38-yard line. An absolutely huge turnover for this defense. They couldn't have picked that off at a better time.
Just a horrible decision by the quarterback trying to force that pass, especially at this point in the game.
It's first and 10. Ball on the 38-yard line. Cincinnati up a point. Fires out to his wideout. He's at midfield. Tackled right around the 42-yard line. So an empty backfield with five wide receivers. Pass is caught, the defense lays him out. They go with a run and he brought down in the backfield. Third down, and they need to get it down to the 32.
Mike 35.
Ready. He's on the run. Room around the corner. Slides down. Down behind the line. Second and 13 coming up here. Ball on the 28. Offense lines up in a five wide set. The defense anticipating pass here. Going right, intercepted. Reception interception breathes new life into this team.
I'm not quite sure I would have made that pass. It obviously wasn't open. This quarterback's got to be more conservative with the ball when they have the lead late in the game like this.
Tries to thread the needle, and it's not going to work. Here he goes. Touchdown. Huge play.
Was a super play by the defender. Excellent interception and an even better return for the score.
And he adds the extra point. Like they're ready for the kickoff. He kicks it off, and he got all of that one. And it goes into the end zone, down for a touchback. So the offense will come back out onto the field, hoping for a little better result than that last pick six.
This quarterback needs to be a little bit more careful because this defense is excellent on capitalizing off the mistakes.
And there isn't anyone who's going to catch this cornerback. Touchdown, Bearcats. So a great play by the defender to give his team 6 points.
That was a very good play, and that will certainly help build his team's momentum.
And he tacks on the extra point. Kicker looks like he's ready to kick this one off. From his own goal line, he's taken down at the 25-yard line. Let's see how the defense responds now, coming off that big play just a moment ago.
This quarterback needs to be a little bit more careful because this defense is excellent on capitalizing off of mistakes.
Defense really missed a golden opportunity there.
That's what separates a good player from a great player. When you have a chance like that, you need to take advantage of it.
Second down, 10 to go. Ball on the 25. And he's tackled in the open field. He's under pressure. Quick throw out to the receiver. Incomplete.
They looked a little sluggish on that series. I'm curious to see if they pick things up when they get the ball back.
Montgomery, the return man. Heading for the corner. He's tackled at the 28-yard line. Both squads are digging in now. Let's see what happens on this next drive. And he's tackled after positive yardage. Fires out to his receiver. They'll bring him down around the 15-yard line. Brought down at the 13-yard line. Scrambling around, and he's sacked.
Not over here.
from the 16-yard line. Third down. Rid of it quickly. Quick throw in the end zone. Touchdown. They call it a catch, but the booth signaled down to the referee that they'd like to take another peek at this.
Man, as I see this play again, it really looks like he made the correct call on the field.
Well, I think the play warranted a review, but the call on the field stands. And he converts the extra point. So that's a five-play, 27-yard drive. And the result, 7 points.
Brad, I thought the offense did a really nice job of mixing up the play calling on that drive. I thought the defense was on its heels most of the drive because of the versatility of the offense.
He'll take it from the two. And he's taken down at the 28. The defense really stepped up to force that three and out on the last drive. Just under three to go in regulation. He's tackled around the 36-yard line. To his tailback. He gets hit out of bounds around the 39-yard line. Throws it to the halfback on the screen. Tackle made at the 43. Out to about the 45-yard line. Slings it. That's a great tackle at the 46. Just over a minute in the fourth quarter. Throws it in and out of his hands. And this is the eighth play of the drive. It's intercepted, and that should do it. Spectacular play there by the linebacker to come away with that interception.
I don't even think the quarterback saw him on that play. He was right there waiting for the ball.
First down, 10 to go. Ball on the 43-yard line.
Here we go.
Gets the ball here and brought down in the backfield.
Yeah.
right around midfield. And the ball game's over. And our final score in this one, Cincinnati 42, Memphis 20. As we finish up the broadcast, what do you have to say about how this game turned out, Kurt?
I thought this would have been a little closer than the scoreboard indicates. Maybe that says something about how good a game they played. Cincinnati had a really tough matchup coming in, but they were prepared, motivated, and came away with a really solid win.
That does it for this edition of NCAA Football 14. For Kirk Herbstreit, I'm Brad Nessler saying so long.